What's up, y'all? It's your boy Jay Mitch coming back to y'all with another video. Today I'm going to be reviewing Polo G, Wishing for a Hero. Like Polo G, he's a Chicago rapper, Chi-Raq rapper. Probably had his influence by G Herbo, Lil Bibby, Chief Keef, Lil Reese, you know, LA Capone, whoever. Any Chicago rapper that was doing that drill stuff during the early teens in the 2000s and stuff. You know, kids like Polo G are now coming out and putting their own little twist on, you know, just hip hop, putting their own twist on that drill stuff that was starting in Chicago. And I took a listen to Polo G's album. I took a listen to it, and I wanted to listen to it first before I did a review, because, or if I do a review at all, I probably won't do it at this point. But I like the music because he's along the lines of like a Lil Baby rapper. He's more lyrical, and you know, G Herbo's more lyrical nowadays, but he's more of a lyrical rapper and is, you know, more of a storyteller, so to say. So I like his music. He seems like he's a reasonable man to, you know, he's got some sense in him. So, I mean, I'm fucking with him. But before we get started, make sure y'all go ahead, tap the subscribe shit. Tap it. Why are you not, you're not subscribed yet. What are you doing? Tap that subscribe button, and then somewhere down there, there's a like button. Hit both of those for me, and then while you're at it, if you could just, it's right next to the like button, hit the little bell, turn on the notifications so I could get at you when I need to, you know. But yeah, so we back into it. Polo G, Wishing for a Hero. Let's get it. True. Not Corona, don't trip. Well respected in this hip hop. Lil Polo be spitting facts. A lot of rappers doing way more stunned than giving back. You ain't my color, then you don't know the struggle of living. Ooh. Black. Cops tell us if we don't test. What type of shit is that, man? If the police shoot at one of my brothers, I'm looking back. We hate each other. So okay, hold on. Because he said some things right there that might have went over y'all's head. So basically, he talking about, you know, Black Lives Matter. He's got a protest going on in here. He's talking about, you know, the police shootings and killing innocent Black men and women in the, you know, cold streets, you know, anywhere in America. I want to address this real quick. For all the people out there that are not of a, you know, darker, lighter Black complexion, you may not notice a difference in the world right now, but right now, I would say it's probably the best time for us Black people and Hispanic people, even Chinese people, people of color. I'm not trying to make this a race thing or nothing. I'm just speaking facts. To probably start operating more collective, you know, as a collective unit, and not hating and just, you know, shooting each other, killing each other. I know there's some things that you got to do when you got to do them, blah, blah, blah. But I'm just talking about, you know, the regular day jealousy or, you know, self-hate in our communities. That it just needs to be expunged, man. I mean, it just needs to be put down. Oh, excuse me. It just needs to be overlooked at this point. Because if you want to be honest, we all in the same boat. I think that's what he's trying to say in this video right now, but we're going to continue to see what he's saying. On the score and go tip for tack. All these shorties want his points, they ain't chasing a different stack. Really risking it all. What's the point when that nigga wrecked? 17 got 40 years in that court when we get cracked. Stuck in the system, they just watching us fail while they sitting back. The government cutting checks, but can't cut a nigga some slack. It's hard to get a job, so we hustling. All right. So look, it looks like they about to go through a story of, you know, how it is for, you know, a man that is in the street that's trying to make some money, making moves, yada yada. And he talking, like, while I'm listening to the song, you know, he's talking about all the things that are going on and have been going on in the world. It's not just with the coronavirus stuff or nothing, you know, like cutting checks and blah blah blah, but man, this is why I like, you know, when kids come out and make some sensible music, it just makes sense. You know, it's just like like that's how hip hop started out. I mean, I know us millennials and baby boomers and whatever have this conversation about hip hop all the time. Hip hop started out as a lyrical thing in the hood, you know, just like rapping about everyday life. So it wasn't about, you know, drugs. I mean, it was about, you know, pushing weight, but it wasn't about like popping, like actually doing the drugs and like, you know, getting yourself down and all that junk that new rappers be talking about. I ain't getting into all that right now, but I'm just talking about how Polo G is, you know, it was directed by him, but I'm sure it was directed by his man, but I'm sure that, you know, he had a storyline that he wanted to get across. You know what I mean? Like, he was like, I want to make sure that this visual has a story. And, you know, I like that about this dude, man. I mean, just listen to his music. You listen to the new album, you'll notice, like, he's not, like, I mean, he talk about regular shit that goes on in the hood, but he don't talk about, you know, nothing that he's not been surrounded by. You know what I mean? Like, he not faking is what I'm trying to say. He not faking, and, you know, he's just telling it how it is. All is set up. No wonder why they call this bitch a trap. Life is messed up, but matter of time till that nigga snap. Post-traumatic stress, so them triggers keep getting tapped. R.P. Malcolm, I promise to conquer and fill them gap. Them corners leave a nigga boxed in, trying to break free. Crazy how I love the same block and try to break me. Pray that I ain't in my own hood when they take me. This all we know, a life of peace where we can't see. I'm from where we unheard and we can't speak. We go to school, they try to tell us what we can't be. Pumping with a $1 billion man like I'm Jay-Z. They killed Martin for dreaming and now I can't sleep. Why would the devil take my brother if he close to me? Now if you stand to my soul, you see my bones in me. We missing you, man. This ain't how this shit's supposed to be. Feel like I'm stuck in the streets, never proposed to me. Out there posted in the field with them soldiers deep. So now the other side won't. So basically, I mean, the story repeats itself over and over again. You know, when you live in this life of, you know, uncertainty, that's exactly what it is. It's just uncertain. You know, there's moments where you had somebody, not to bring up 6ix9ine, but you had somebody in a position that's not supposed to be in that position or thinks they're ready for that and they're not. And things go left and they get pulled in. And, you know, basically the whole operation gets shut down. And the niggas that was trying to make some money and go somewhere end up getting the worst of it because, you know, they were just trying to do something that would further, you know, them socially and economically. But that's all that this storyline is, man. But yeah, it continues to repeat itself. Put a hole in me, like every day might be the end of the road for me. We die young, so I could picture older me. Fighting demons, let them drugs take control of me. All in my head, going kill what they told to me. Remember, we ain't have a thing, same clothes, so we hard body. That's how them situations molded me. Needed money and grew accustomed to this fast life. Pressure from this way, I'm living so fast life. She got me stretched 365 nights. Shut the cop. Against us like we don't have rights. It don't matter what this money and this fame can get. I've been hurting, trying to smile through the pain and tears. Wish we can go back to them days when we played as kids. Change, it's just the way it is. That's just the way it is. Ooh. Some things will never change. that piano. There it is, y'all. It's a quick little video for y'all today. That's the first time I seen the music video. I was on Twitter and I saw a little clip of it, but I wanted to come check it out with y'all, make sure that y'all got my full honest opinion of it. But Polo G, wishing for a hero. You know, he's got that, that's just the way it is. And yeah, sometimes that's just the way it is. Sometimes, you know, basically some things will never change. And, you know, he's just looking at that and reflecting, like, you know, he's going to a new level as an artist, as a man, and taking his family to a new level right now, being an up-and-coming artist. So, you know, I'm sure that he's sitting back right now and looking at, you know, a lot of situations that he's put in, and a lot of people around him that want something and he can't give it to them, you know, or they need it and he can't give it to them. So, but shout out to Polo G. Shout out to y'all. Once again, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and let me know if you were liking this video. Also, if you want any of those Tunnel Vision items, I'm going to leave all the contact links down below. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Holla at y'all. Let me know how you feeling. Peace.
You the one that I really wanna keep. When we make love, they can hit in the street. Put the dick deep down while I'm feeling on your knees. When I go down, I don't care if I can breathe. I don't ever wanna leave. I got what you need. I don't ever wanna leave. You the one that I really wanna keep. When we make